بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى اما بعد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في الكلام المجيد والفرقان الحميد بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغوا عني ولو آية صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي ربی زدنی علما سبحانک لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انک انت العلیم الحکیم مائی موسٹ ریسپیکٹ برادرز اینڈ ایلڈرز ناظرین ان اسلام السلام علیکم رحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ فسٹ آف آل وی شوڈ بی تھینک فل ٹو اللہ سبحانہ و تعالیٰ بی گریٹفل to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who blessed us with Islam, Iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us last breath with Iman and al-Islam. Islam is the rights to pay the haqooq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, haqooq wa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Haqq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have firm belief in la ilaha illallah and to obey him 100%. And haqq of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammadur Rasulullah, to obey him. Haqq-e Rasul, mashallah, to have love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to believe in khatm-e nubuwwat, to obey him, to have his fikr, hum and gham, what he had. In the same way, Quran-e-Majeed has rights on us, have haqooq on us. The very first right of Quran-e-Majeed is this, to have correct aqeedah about Quran-e-Majeed. Quran-e-Majeed is the final book revealed on the final prophet, Hazrat Muhammad ibn Abdullah, born in Saudi Arabia about 1400 years ago. We should have correct aqeedah also. This is Kalamullah. Quran-e-Majeed is a Kalamullah. And we know how much Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal Rahimullah sacrifice to uphold this aqeedah. The second haqq of Quran-e-Majeed, we should have respect and honor physically, externally, and internally. We should not open Mus'haf Quran-e-Majeed without wuzu. Mashruq Quran-e-Majeed, we open with wuzu and can recite it. About Quran-e-Majeed, in the cellular telephone, Sal Ulma have fatwa. Maybe you can touch without, you can read without wuzu. So we should reference respect of Quran-e-Majeed in our heart. We should not put on the ground. No. Even I always tell the students, even don't put your math science book on the ground, because this is ilm. Ilm without adab, we cannot get it. The third right of Quran-e-Majeed is this. We should be able to recite with correct pronunciation and intonation, with tajweed. Arabic language is very comprehensive as well as delicate language. Even prolonging the sound of any word, any harf, the meaning are changed totally. Example. One example is very famous. When we pronounce qaf from the halaq, then the meaning is heart, alb. When we pronounce with the tongue, with the lips, not with the halaq, qalb means dog. Another example. In the Surah Wadduha, Wala Saufa Yu'tika Rabbuka Fatardua. The meaning, O my beloved Prophet, very soon we will bless you and we will become happy with you. Wala Saufa means very soon we bless you. Very soon, the meaning very soon. Wala Saufa. If we pronounce Wala Saufa, let us prolong the sound of La. Instead of saying La, we say La Wala Saufa. The meaning totally changed. We will not. So, it's very dangerous. So therefore, we should be able to recite Quran and Majid with correct pronunciation and intonation with tajweed. We should learn it. Go to Qari Sahib. Go to internet. But his situation, we normally think our children should go to Qari Sahib, best Qari, he learn Quran. What about us? What about us? This is not a wajib only for the children, it is for the adult also. For learning Islam has no age limit. Imam Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala advised, O my beloved Prophet, make this dua, Khul Rabbi Zidni Ilma, say, Ya Allah, increase my knowledge. Imam Rasul Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been advised, you remain my student until last breath. So where we stand? We old people, even 78 year old, he did not learn Quran with tajweed from the Qari Sahib, just from mashallah, village Maulana mashallah. So we should also try to go to Qari Sahib, please learn Quran, how to recite with tajweed. You learn, then you teach your wife, Zawja. I will recommend you become teacher of your wife. Or your wife should learn Quran with tajweed online from some woman. Never ever encourage your daughter or your wife to learn tajweed online from any man. This is masala of ghair mahram. They are dangerous. Now, the fourth haq of Quran-e-Majid is this. We should recite orally, hifaz, some part of Quran. Surah Fatiha, last juz of Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Yasin, Surah Ali Imran, last surah of 30th chapter, 30th juz. Some surahs, easy surah, at least everybody should be able to do the hifaz of those surah. Imam Rasul Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam had desire that each and every my ummati should have Surah Yasin in the heart. So I recommend everybody learn Surah Yasin, memorize Surah Yasin by heart. Then at time of death, it will help us. Plus, this surah is called Mushkal Kusha Surah. When we have any problem, read Surah Yasin. Inshallah, it will help us. Very simple way. If start reading every day without fail, inshallah, time will come, you will be able to memorize it. Now, the fifth haqq of Quran-e-Majeed is this. We should recite Quran-e-Majeed with translation and also tafsir. We ajami who don't know Arabic language, we should know what the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just reciting with tajweed, just Quran-e-Majeed, not knowing the meaning, how we will know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanding us. So therefore, I will recommend, please, what juz you read, what ruku you read, Quran-e-Majeed, recite Quran-e-Majeed, please read the meaning of that juz or ruku. Read the meaning as well as read the tafsir of that. In this context, you have to buy certain tafsir. I will recommend some. Don't read any tafsir. I mean, don't listen any lecture of tafsir without asking your ulama haq, who is this alim is. Now, to my opinion, there are a lot of every tafsir good, but certain are very good for this age level. Tafsir Mu'arif al-Quran, written by late Mufti Azam Pakistan, Hazrat Muhammad Shafi, Sahab Rahmatullah Alayh, the father of Hazrat Taqi Usmani, Damat Barakatuhu. This tafsir is beautiful. English for our children, English speaking, English version is available. And Urdu also, of course, and Bangladeshi language also is a tafsir. This is a little lengthy. Another brief tafsir is Tafsir-e-Usmani, written by Hazrat Allama Shabir Ahmad Usmani, who did an opening ceremony of Pakistan in 1947. His tafsir. Tafsir Bayan al-Quran. And tafsir lectures, subhanallah. Our Mufti, our Grand Mufti, Hazrat Mufti Munir Ahmad Akhun, who is the in charge of this masjid, mashallah, his tafsir, every day he does tafsir and his lectures are available. Please listen to him. And moreover, you can listen to the tafsir lectures of Hazrat Taqi Usmani, Damat Barakatuhu, and some other ulama to whom your scholar recommend it. Now, the sixth haqq of Quran-e-Majeed is this, that we should practice what we read, recite, learn, know the meaning, know the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should put into practice. Quran-e-Majeed came for amal, not just for reading. Of course, if we recite Quran-e-Majeed, it is benefit. We get sawab. Alif, lam, mim, each harf will bless us with 10 hasanat. But Quran is just not came for sawab. This book to practice. It contains do, and don't. But when you read, recite tafsir, please don't start giving fatwa. There are two kinds of ahkam. Targhib wa tarhib, what Allah said, do it, simple ahkam, make salat, do hajj, pay zakat, don't do zina, don't go to creep to zina, don't backbite, don't steal. So these are simple command, do not to do. We can follow that. But certain ayat belong to the ulama to deduce misail. This is their job. The simple commandment you can follow easily. And there is one strange thing going on in the public. Oh, don't read Quran with meaning. No, no, no. It's very difficult. Very difficult. And they made the ummah scared not to read the meaning and tafsir of Quran. That's something. Please, when Quran and Majid claims itself, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ, we have made Quran easy for understanding. We have made Quran easy for understanding. How come people propagate that Quran and Majid is very hard to understand? No, of course, certain ayat you cannot, but most of you can understand. Simple to obey, to do amal on Quran. So sixth haqq of Quran and Majid is this: to put into action what we recite. And seventh haqq of Quran and Majid is this: to propagate Quran, to give dawah bil Quran. Tabligh and dawah bil Quran is the best, of course. So we have to propagate Quran to Muslimin as well as non-Muslimin. You might have heard so many non-Muslim, they get shahada just by reading the English translator like glorious Quran. That's it. So many non-Muslim accepting Islam by reading just English version of the Quran Majid. You can distribute in your office, in your workplace, to your American friend. You can give them the translated Quran Majid, like glorious Quran. You can buy it. Of course, don't give them Arabic written context Quran, give English. This is the best gift. These days, you can exchange gift with your friend who are not Muslim. Give them this as a good gift. MashaAllah, this is your job. Second, we are supposed to give dawah to non-believer or Muslim. And I make dua, Ya Allah, each and every American who's a non-believer, Ya Allah, your Jannah is very vast, no problem, please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give them guidance and also bless them Jannah. Why not? We should make dua for them. So these are the haqooq of Quran and Majid I mentioned before you. The seven haqooq. Now I am giving you homework today. The first haqq of Quran I told you, we shall correct aqidah. Second, we should respect honor Quran. Number three, we should learn Quran with tajweed. Number four, we should memorize some Quran. Number five, we should know the meaning of Quran and Majid and tafsir. And we should put into practice, and we should propagate Quran where we stand. The seven rights of Quran I mentioned before you. How many rights we are paying? How many rights? Maybe one or two. Therefore, Quran says, in the day of Qiyamah, Rasool-e-Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam will complain. This is ayat in the Quran Majeed. وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّي إِنَّكُمْ مِتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّي إِنَّكُمْ مِتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا يَا اللَّهُ My nation has forgotten Quran. They did not pay the rights of Quran. Please, we should do tawbah today. Ya Allah, today I was not paying all rights of Quran and Majid. I shall learn Quran. I will learn Quran with tajweed. I will know the meaning of Quran. I learn the tafsir of Quran. Listen to the tafsir of Quran. I'll put into practice Quran. I'll propagate Quran. Wa akhir damana alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Jazakallah khair. Shukran kaseera. 130. Now, Sunte Palne, please. Make Sunna, right? Yeah, make Sunna. Yeah.